I want to be very cautious. I want to be very judicious because I am not 18 years old. I like one of our portions of season 2. Gusto ko yung cake talk, tawag namin nun. Like, you want to host. You come by the show, you get invited to the show, and then you do something as a host. Maybe you do a public speaking piece, or you do an imaginary talk show. And then I'll be there. There'll be a talk producer from ABS-CBN. We'll do comments. We'll try to connect you to a producer of one of the talk shows. I'm excited about it. I'm excited about it because possibilities are infinite. Brilliant, beautiful, wonderful possibilities are present in that particular segment. So I'm particularly excited about it. Because I've done the takeaway at the end, the interviewing I've done. Yung interviews naman kasi, Ann, you wouldn't know what works until you do it. Until you do it. No matter what kind of preparation you do, and until you're there, you wouldn't know the dance. You wouldn't know the dance. Another portion is when we do the news, we've done it. So it's really that portion. When we see talent and we talk about it, we give pieces of advice, and we answer questions. Kasi doon ang daming pwedeng mangyari, and that excites me. Learnings during the pandemic, marami, and I spoke about them kanina.
So this is like a mentorship portion, also. Right?
Yeah. Conte. Oh, it's sharing your pieces of advice with, you know, a wannabe host, star, etc. I'd like a serious discussion, for example, with what has a star become? Kasi iba na ngayon ang star eh. Diba? Yan ang, you know, I'm writing this book that I haven't, Mark is listening now. I haven't been able to finish, but hopefully in the next few months, matapos ko. 13 things I know that you may want to know about managing public figures in the Philippines. That's my premise. I'd like to be able to discuss this because nag-pivot eh, ang konsepto ng management, ng pagiging sikat. Nagbago ang kulay, nagbago ang dynamics, nagbago ang texture. So I'm studying this right now. Nag-umpisa tayo sa probinsya, ay sanay ako sa payak na pamumuhay. I'm used to the simple life, but I also spent a lot of years getting used to the gifts, ika nga, ng ating pinaghirapan. Ang natutunan ko is I learned to go back to the basics. I learned to go back to living a simple life. Natutunan ko na kaya naman pala kahit wala kang bagong sapatos ng isang taon. Natutunan ko na to go back more not naman more often, but natutunan ko bumalik sa core ko. Hindi naman talaga ako marunong magkutsara. Bulkas, ang tawag natin rito sa Waray. Talbos yan sa kamay nilaan. And this is not meant to impress anybody about a simple life because this is really my core. Masaya ako sa kamote at galunggong, not because I want people to think that ay si Boy kumakain. Hindi po, yun talaga ang kinakain ko bago ako natuto kumain doon sa mga kaartihan. I never complained about it, no. But most important lesson, Ricky, that I realized, because remember nag-umpisa ang COVID, nanay just passed on, that was December 1 of 2019. Huh? I read a lot of books. I listened to a lot of speeches. I listened to a lot of TED Talks, watched them. Hindi ako sigurado kung si Bill Gates. But my biggest learning is that I want to become a better person to my family, to friends. I want to become a better person to myself. I want to befriend myself. because in the words, I think, of Bill Gates, we were confronted with our own finitude. Simply said, the biggest realization was that we are all going to die. We might as well be good. Nandun ako, Marinel, sa I want to be very cautious. I want to be very judicious because I am not 18 years old. Okay? I am not talagang 18 ang I'm not 30, 40 years old. So, I'd like to be very careful. Ang priority ko is to take care of myself. I want to strengthen my immune system. I want to eat the kind of food. I want to sleep 8-9 hours a day para makalaban. Kinaya ko ng isang taon, gusto ko sana ipagpatuloy. I'd like to entertain the idea of vaccination siguro September, October. I want to watch the world. Titingnan ko muna. My friends, I have a doctor friend, I was talking to him just before this media conference. Sabi niya, tapos na ako my first dose and I'll let you know. I want professional advice, what's best. Pero ngayon, ayoko muna. Tinawagan ko ngayon yung kaibigan ko, halimbawa, the infectious medicine expert of St. Luke's Hospital, Dr. Mario Panaligan. Sabi ko, Dr. Mario, paliwanag mo naman sa akin. Dr. Dennis Ngo, the glory of mine. I'm calling doctors. I mean, let us know because I want to know more so that when I get into, you know, the decision if as to whether I want me and my family to be vaccinated, I am well informed.